Good morning. I'm Mieke Oostra, Professor Applied Urban Energy Transition at Utrecht University of Applied Sciences in the Netherlands. The title of this presentation is Appropriate Technology Development for a Post-Carbon Built Environment by Open Building Principles. In my chair, we work on concepts, products and processes to make the existing built environment energy neutral and circular. Together with partners, we first started to convert row housing into energy neutral, and currently we are advancing to high-rise apartment buildings. In the first part of this presentation, we will define the current challenge and the resulting preconditions. The next part touches on what it means for planning the future and how open building can contribute in finding appropriate solutions. Finally, I will show what this means for technology development. We are all familiar with the Paris Agreements and the IPCC report of 2014. It introduced the concept of planetary boundaries. Global agreements were made to jointly address these boundaries, to limit CO2 emissions and keep an eye on the remaining carbon budget to keep temperature rise below 1.5 degrees centigrade. We will have to make sure the main engine behind our prosperity and well-being, our economies, respect these planetary boundaries. We do this in order to survive as mankind, so it is essential to include the basic human needs of everyone. Keith Raworth, an economist at Oxford University, translated this into the concept of the donut economy. The outside of the donut visualizes the ecological ceiling. Overshoot here will deteriorate our living conditions. The inside of the donut forms the social foundation. Every person needs basics in the form of clean water, food and energy, access to health, education, housing and an income, and the right to live a peaceful life in freedom. My team and its partners are translating the demands of the restricted carbon budget for the Dutch built environment. The main assignment will be renovating the existing building stock. We have made covenants with all main societal stakeholders. In the next 10 to 30 years, we will have to renovate 8 million buildings at a staggering rate of 1,000 a day. We know from experience that planning for the future is inherently risky. Not everything can be forecasted, like black swan events as the big financial crisis. While technology trends can be predicted with reasonable ease, social change cannot. This uncertainty regarding the future requires strategies that perform well and leave room for viable alternatives. Fundamental societal changes, the industrial revolutions, come in waves, according to the wave theory developed by Schumpeter, Freeman and Peres. The current paradigm shift has replaced the old logic of affordable energy and transport with a new logic, that of affordable information and information transfer. In the Netherlands, we have become used to the government taking a lead in major societal developments. This top-down planning has proven to be efficient. However, this time, the challenge is much more complex. The current energy transition requires a vast array of technological solutions that have to be combined into the specifics of the physical and social context. Citizens also see the necessity for change and have started local initiatives, taking matters into their own hands. Ideally, the two approaches of top-down and bottom-up are combined in the middle-up-down approach, exploiting the helicopter's perspective from the top with the wisdom of the crowd from the bottom. Open building is a clever combination of principles that helps us to create a middle-up-down approach. It helps with the decision-making on different levels, providing ordinary people the opportunity to mold their own house. From the environmental point of view, open building helps to prolong use and reuse, and open building allows to include changing appropriate technology. So what is appropriate technology in our case? There's a wide array to choose from, although not everything will be feasible. And what is possible needs to be assessed for future-proofing and flexibility. This question should be addressed on a macro, meso and micro level. For now, I will focus on the micro level, dwellings in particular. When making a home energy neutral, it is easiest to look to readily available options. In doing the math, you can determine what kind of mix of technologies will fit best with a specific kind of building, complementing measures that were already taken, and including the tenant's preferences. Urgenda, for instance, helps homeowners to make these decisions. However, if the challenge is met head-on, you determine the requirements you want to reach first, forcing the market to deliver what you need. When we did this for row housing in the Netherlands, we achieved a reduction of construction time of 90% and a cost reduction of 50%, thereby keeping housing costs level for tenants. This was a leap everyone deemed impossible. The remodeling of the sector, or at least the companies that were involved in or inspired by the specific Green Deal, took to develop building components like integrated facade elements to the market. Now there are not only separate energy measures to choose from, but new integrated retrofitting concepts to make a house energy neutral in one step and integrated building components for a step-by-step approach. It proved to be essential to come up with new financial and legal arrangements in order to make a complete makeover feasible. The idea is that financially, a retrofit will lower the tenant's energy bill towards zero, freeing up money to finance the retrofit. This is called the energy performance fee. For private house owners, a different arrangement has proven necessary, the building-related loan. In neighborhoods, social arrangements were made to improve the rollout. Meetings, expert meetings and expositions were held in schools and community centers. Excursions were organized, energy coaches were hired, and people that already converted their homes were assisting as ambassadors. This helped immensely, although the quest to discover how to make the best mix of ingredients for a sound neighborhood approach remains. There is an overwhelming challenge we are facing, trying to stay within the planetary boundaries whilst also dealing with a sound social fundament necessary to create the conditions for people to prosper. There is a list of technological, financial and social innovations, either available or in development, that needs to start operating as an ecosystem in order to make the leap we need. As architects and urban planners, we know that addressing these issues successfully can never be done without considering the quality of the built environment or without providing people the opportunity to make their own decisions. Architecture and urbanism have a huge responsibility to include issues important to ordinary people, like affordability, jobs, and quality of life. Open building will help in advancing some of the major issues in our future endeavors. Thank you for your kind attention.